United States has declared war on Germany. The newspapers say the American troops will not start arriving in France for another couple of months. But there was no question that the Americans would join the fighting, and a lot of them could very well end up dead. Soon, spring is coming.
I love spring!
Yeah, me too. We don't need to work in the new it's not in school anymore.
It was hard.
I'm ready for the ride. Now I'm getting the drum to school. I used to leave this one as before.
Yeah, it was not a bad thing for the winter. Right, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like it, man.
Like it or not, you must follow our lesson.
Yeah. As Mr. Sensor read the poem, Richard was mesmerized. Some of his favorite poets were Shakespeare, Lord Byron and Shelley, even though they spoke in fancy language that he could not always understand.
Digital!
I beg you, pardon.
My father's poetry books, please. And he shows how that was report. I agree, 200%. It's so S-I-S-S-Y, Sissy.
It should not, class. I have read the work of this particular today for a special reason. It is about Mr. George Cooper. Have you heard about him before?
Thank you.
So one of the girls from his grade standing alone in the hallway, Hannah Shaka, was a pretty blue-eyed girl with blonde hair that looked like corn syrup. Just like the other boys, Richard also had sneaked many a look in her direction. Richard hurried to catch up with some classmates walking away from school. Blanche Peeble, a dark-haired girl whose parents owned the grocery store, was one of them. He saw that Abner Lewis and Harry Carver were with the group too.
Dear Mr. Kimmel, my name is Richard Knight and I'm in the 10th grade. I live on a farm near Turtle Lake, Iowa. This morning, my English teacher read your poem Trees to us. I thought it was very fun. I borrowed your book from my teacher and I've been reading your poem this afternoon. I like them all. I can tell that you are the kind of man who cares about living things. I wish I could meet you. I also want to say that I think it's very brave of you to enlist in the army. I admire you for being willing to fight for your country. I will pray for your safety. I write poetry myself. It's not really fun poetry like what you write, but I do the best I can. I keep all my poems in a locked desk drawer. I never show them to anybody, not even my pa or my brother Gus or my sister Angie.
Richie got out a pencil and a piece of paper and started to write. About 20 minutes later, he paused for a moment.
What else did I want to say? Let me think. Alright, here we go.
So much of the time, I feel very alone, even when I'm around other people. Nobody seems to think or feel as I do. That makes me feel less alone. Nobody I know writes poetry. Some people I know even believe that writing poetry isn't manly. Although, of course, I know better than that. I'm afraid if I tell anybody about my poetry, it will only make things worse for me. What do you think I should do, Mr. Kimmel? Should I be brave and tell everybody about my poem, or should I keep on hiding them? I know you are a busy man, getting ready to go to work and all. But if you have a little time, I sure like to hear from you.
15 minutes later.
Well, I'm done. Before I
pull up, I'm ready to take it again. Richard folded out the letter, put it in an envelope and scaled it. Then, he addressed it to Joyce Kimmel in care of the New York Times and put a stamp on it. He knew if he put the letter in the mailbox in front of your house, someone might see it before the postman came. Richard decided to drop it off at the post office before school tomorrow. Of course, he did not really expect an answer from Joyce Kimmel. Why would a famous, busy man answer a letter from 15-year-old farm boy from Iowa? Little did he know that it would be the start of a journey of friendship and valuable lessons in his life.